Hello ladies and gentlemen, I am Docs and this is the Buy It or Not mini review series. Today we are going to take a look at Banished, a new title that appeared on Steam today. This is a medieval city simulator. So basically you get a bunch of people and you have to make them do whatever it takes to survive in the woods, valleys or mountains, depending on what you choose. This is a not so simple city simulator, so basically it's actually going to kill you a few times before you get the hang of it. I've been playing it on easy for a little while now and I've kind of died most of the time. Also, it's the learning curve for this game is rather harsh, to say so. But once you get the hang of it, you'll keep on playing it until the break of dawn. As proved, at this hour is about 2 a.m. Over here, and I've been playing this for I think 4 hours straight now. But let us move on and see a little of the gameplay of the game. I need to warn you, this is going to be longer and not mini review, but mostly let's play combined with a little review of some things of the game. So we're going to start a random seed with the valley's terrain type, a medium map. I probably won't survive long enough to make use of a full large map. We want a fair climate. Now let's put a mild climate to make it easier. No disasters. I'm sorry, but without disasters, it's hard enough. And easy starting conditions, just to be able to fiddle around and show you what the game can do. So let us start up. So the premise of the game is that your group of settlers has been banished from where they used to live, and now they have to make a new life for themselves, start a village, town, or whatever else you will end up building. Who knows, maybe an evil empire. At the start, since we're playing the easy campaign, we will get a bunch of resources. We will have 6 full families that we can use. But first things first. So the first thing you will want to do is put the game on pause. So here you can speed up time to make things go faster, so you don't have to wait a long time. But be careful, because if you click on something else, this time control, the device disappears, and you might leave this on 10x instead of 1x, and you will wonder why people start dying and you don't have resources and other stuff like that. So first things first, tools and reports. These are the most important windows that you will need to look at most of the time. So here are the town statistics. These tell you how much of each resource you have stored, what's the health of the citizens and their happiness, plus other different tools, clothes and so on. Also tells you the date, the season, and this is the number of adults, students and children. Also, this is a thing you need to keep an eye on, the current weather temperature, because once this gets below zero, people will need to have firewood and clothes, so they don't freeze to death. Okay, next one is the events that occurred. So this is the window where you will see what's happening at the current moment in the game. So here you will get resource notifications, that notifications, and so on and so forth. Okay, you will have here a minimap. This depends if you want one or not. You can probably do without one. And here is the most important window that you will be using a lot. So put it somewhere that you're comfortable to getting to it. And let us move forward. Also, I suggest, please, before starting playing, go and run through the tutorial, even if you just skip through it. Otherwise, you will probably end up clicking buttons here and there without ever getting anywhere. I've done that myself. I've watched a few Twitch streamers do it, and this is not your two steps SimCity game. So this is a little bit more complicated. Okay, what else? Okay, resources here. This will allow you to control resources, so you don't get too many resources of one kind. You can put different limits on the resources. These are the default ones. Once you start playing and getting a feel for it, you can alter each of the resources to your playstyle. Okay, so this is a tool that if you have three things building and you want one of them to be built first, you just select this tool and you click on the building that you want to build first. When you have a tool selected, if you right click, it will deselect the tool. Paths tool, this will show you the paths that that your people take while moving around from their homes to their places of work and so on. Here you can select camera locations that you can just move from one to another, so you don't have to move with the mouse at the edge of the screen or using the minimap to jump from here and there. But these are not that important. Okay, so let's move on to the professions window. This is the one that you will need the most. And to start things off, we will start by clearing out an area. To clear out an area, you go to the removal and destruction tools. This here allows you to remove things from a specific area. You can select if you want to remove buildings, roads, or one of the three types of resources. You can also remove all resources from a selected area. So we will start by doing that, and by building a farm. We will need a farm because otherwise we'll probably starve to death. Okay, so this is the remove area tool. We have selected this. Unfortunately, it's not really visible what we just did. You'll just have to keep in mind where you select that area until your people actually start going over and cleaning it up. Next, we will build a okay, so here this is the food production tab. Here you have different types of food sources. So all of these need to grow and develop through the seasons, because this game has four seasons every year. And for example, if you build a pasture for cattle, you will actually need to wait from one year to the next, so the cattle has calves, and then the calves grow, and then you can use them for food. Hunting cabin, gatherer's hut, and the fishing dock are the ones that you can use right away, because they actually use natural resources. So we'll start by building a fishing hut. To place a structure with the correct orientation, you use the R and the T keys to rotate it, and then you try to find the perfect spot to place the structure that you want. This, the fishing hut, is always kind of tricky, so let's just I want somewhere with a wider area of okay, let's say that here's good. Then people can move anywhere on the map, but if you have different places connected between them with roads, people will move faster from one place to another. We won't be using stone roads at the moment, although they are much faster, but we do not have that much stone, and what stone we have we'll need to use for other purposes. So let's just start a dirt road from the middle of the town and then take it all the way to the fishing hut. So now we can actually start the or maybe okay no let's just let's build another food source, and this time we'll build a gatherer's hut. So a gatherer's hut is a hut that has an area from which it collects resources. If you cut down trees and the resources from that area, it will have really poor performance. So we will select a area that is out of reach of the workers that will have gathering wood, stone and iron. So let's put the gatherer's hut over here. Why not? Okay, so we've placed it there, and now to remember, while we still remember where we placed it, we'll just take a dirt road from it to the dirt road we had before.